Hello everyone, warm welcome you all. In today's video, we are going to discuss an important MCQs of UGC NET English Literature. Yes friends, previous year question paper with explanation hum yahan pe discuss karenge jo UGC NET English Literature ka July 2018 ka paper is video mein hum discuss karne wale hain. So friends, is video mein kuch important एक्सप्लेनेशन के साथ जो क्वेश्चंस के एक्सप्लेनेशंस हैं, किस तरीके से क्वेश्चंस पुट अप होते हैं यूजीसी नेट एग्जाम्स में इंग्लिश लिटरेचर से रिलेटेड, क्या सेक्शंस होते हैं, क्वेश्चन का क्या फॉर्म होता है, क्या पैटर्न होता है, वी विल ऑल डिस्कस दैट इन हियर. एंड प्लीज वॉच इट टिल द एंड बिकॉज यू आर गोइंग टू नो सम इम्पॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन रिलेटेड टू द यूजीसी नेट एग्जाम्स पेपर एंड ऑल्सो वट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आस्क्ड इन यूजीसी नेट exams. So without any delay, let's move on to the questions of the English Literature July 2018 UGC NET paper. Let's discuss the very first question of the video. Which narrative poem by Lord Tennyson presents the story of a fisherman turned merchant sailor who after a shipwreck is marooned on a desert island? We have the option and the correct answer is Enoch Arden, which was a narrative poem and published in 1864. Ye narrative poem thi Enoch Arden and the main character name was also Enoch Arden. Jo main character tha, jo sailor tha, jo fisherman tha aur jo merchant mein change hua hai, turned hua hai, he was the character of this poem. Main character and his name was also Enoch Arden. Narrative poem usko bolte hain which has a story form. Jo story form mein poem hoti hai, that is called narrative poem. And all other poems of Tennyson, Crossing the Bar, which was published in 1889, Titonus, it was also published in 1860, and Maud, the other poem, and it was published in 1855. Next question we have. In Memorial Verses, which was published in 1850 by Matthew Arnold, pays tribute to three great poets. Who were they? We have the option and the correct answer is Jortha, Wordsworth, Byron. This was an elegy. Memorial Verses, which was published in 1850, was an elegy. The praise and lament to Wordsworth. William Wordsworth ki praise mein, when William Wordsworth, after the demise of William Wordsworth, this poem was composed by Matthew Arnold. And Matthew Arnold in is poem mein, apne is पोएटिक कॉम्पोजिशन में जो प्रेज किया हुआ है वो तीन ग्रेट पोएट्स को ऑफ दैट टाइम, ऑफ द टाइम ऑफ द 1850 और दैट अराउंड, और विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ के टाइम के जो तीन ग्रेट पोएट्स थे उनको डिस्क्राइब किया है, उनकी प्रेज की हुई है, जोर्था, वर्ड्सवर्थ एंड बेरॉन. नेक्स्ट वी हैव क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री ऑफ द वीडियो फ्रॉम द पेपर जुलाई 2018 यूजीसी नेट. हु अमंग द फॉलोइंग English playwrights wrote screenplays or novels such as Marshall Proust's In Search of Lost Time, John Fowell's French Lieutenant Women, and Margaret Atwood's Handmaid's Tale. This was the works composed by on the novels Marshall Proust, In Search of the Lost Time, John Fowell's French Lieutenant's Women, and Margaret Atwood's Handmaid's Tale. And in these novels, that writer, Harold Pinter, we have the correct answer is Harold Pinter, who was a Nobel Prize winner. He was the English-British playwright, jo British dramatist the, Harold Pinter. Unhone, he had also written screenplays. Unhone screenplays likhe hue, and unhone, in jo important नॉवेलिस्ट हैं उनके नॉवेल्स के लिए उन्होंने स्क्रीन प्लेज लिखे हुए हैं. लेट्स डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द वीडियो. द ईयर इन इंग्लिश लिटरेरी हिस्ट्री बिटवीन 1649 एंड 1660 आर नोन एज, दिस वाज नोन एज द कॉमनवेल्थ पीरियड इन हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. एंड दिस कॉमनवेल्थ पीरियड पार्लियामेंट रूल्ड ओवर इंग्लैंड इंस्टेड ऑफ monarchy government or instead of king. Next question we have, question number 5th, R.K. Narayan Swami and Friends, which was published in 1935, which game offers Swami the best kind of emotional release from the strains and pleasure of disagreeable circumstances? This was the novel by R.K. Narayan Swami and Friends. He was the Indian English literature novelist and which was published in 1935. में बात की जा रही है किस गेम को स्वामी बेस्ट काइंड ऑफ इमोशनल वो ऑफर करता है, बेस्ट काइंड ऑफ इमोशनल रिलीज, दैट इज क्रिकेट. नेक्स्ट वी हैव क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. विलियम ब्लेक ऑन रेनॉल्ड्स विच वॉज पब्लिश इन 1798 एक्सप्रेस द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर व्हेन ही सेड दैट to generalize is to dot dot dot, to particularize is the alone distinction of merit. Fill in the blanks, the blank option, and the correct answer is an idiot. This was William Blake has written on Reynolds, which was published in 1798. His views about the importance of a particular, उन्होंने अपने views दिए हैं जो importance of particular है उसके ऊपर. Question number 7 of the video is, which of the following was not a dialect of Old English? We have the option and the correct answer is number 1, Irish language dialect was not an Old English dialect. All other Northumbrian, Mercian and Kentish, these all are Old English dialect. And friends, whatever question I am discussing here, they all are asked in UGC NET exams July 2018. जो इंग्लिश लिटरेचर का पेपर हुआ था जुलाई 2018 का, उसमें ये क्वेश्चंस पूछे गए हैं. सो दीज ऑल आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस. सो यू कैन थिंक अबाउट दिस कि कहाँ से क्वेश्चंस पूछे जाते हैं, किस तरीके के क्वेश्चंस पूछे जाते हैं इंग्लिश लिटरेचर के पेपर में. एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन नोट डाउन बिकॉज सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चन रिपीटेडली आस्क इन एग्जाम. कई बार वो क्वेश्चंस पूछे जाते हैं इन अ सम वे, इन सम अदर वे. तो क्वेश्चन का पैटर्न समझना बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. और क्वेश्चंस कहाँ से मोस्टली आस्क किए जा रहे हैं ये भी क्वेश्चन बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. मैं अपने बैक टू बैक वीडियोस में इंपॉर्टेंट जो 2018 जुलाई के जो भी क्वेश्चंस आए हुए हैं वो सब मैं यहाँ पे डिस्कस करने वाली हूँ. एंड मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, एंथोनी वर्गेस नॉवेल पब्लिश इन 1993 इज कॉल्ड अ डेड मैन इन डेप्थफोर्ड. हु इज द सेंट्रल कैरेक्टर टू हुम The title refers. A Dead Man in Deptford was the title of the novel, last novel of Anthony Burgess, which was published in 1993. In 1993 mein novel published hui thi Anthony Burgess ki, jiska title tha A Dead Man in Deptford. And ye kisko central character kaun tha is novel ka jisko ye title refer ki gayi thi. We have the option and the correct answer is Christopher Marlowe. Christopher Marlowe was the central character of this novel of Anthony Burgess and A Dead Man in Deptford. And इस नॉवल में जो डिस्कस किया गया है दैट इज रिलेटेड टू द लाइफ एंड द अचीवमेंट्स एंड द थिंग्स हैपेंड इन द लाइफ ऑफ क्रिस्टोफर मार्लो. उसको इस नॉवल में एंथोनी वर्गीस ने डिस्कस किया हुआ है. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वी हैव, चूज द करेक्ट क्रोनोलॉजिकल सीक्वेंस. वी हैव द सीक्वेंस हियर, द एंड द करेक्ट क्रोनोलॉजिकल सीक्वेंस वी हैव विलियम कैंगस्टन प्रिंटिंग प्रेस द फर्स्ट इंग्लिश बुक विच वॉज पब्लिश इन 1473. We have Total's Miscellany, Songs and Sonnets, which was published in 1557. William Shakespeare's First Folio, which was published in 1623 by his two friends. And Milton's Areopagitica, which was published in 1644. This was a kind of work that was related to the release of the press or freedom of the press. So the correct chronological sequence we have. फिर विलियम कैंगस्टन प्रेस जो फर्स्ट इंग्लिश बुक थी पब्लिश हुई थी 1473 में. टोटल मिसलनरी जो पब्लिश हुई है 1557 में. विलियम शेक्सपियर का फर्स्ट फोलियो जो पब्लिश हुआ है 1623 में उनके फ्रेंड्स के थ्रू. एंड ऑल्सो जॉन मिल्टन्स एरियोपेजिटिका विच वॉज पब्लिश इन 1644. दिस वॉज द क्रोनोलॉजिकल सेकेंड. क्रोनोलॉजिकल सीक्वेंस वो होता है जहाँ पे आपको क्रोनोलॉजिकली चीज़ों को अरेंज करना होता है. दैट इज वॉज इन दिस क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड. 10 we have, what does the phrase art pictura poesies from Horace Ars Poetica, art of poetry mean? This was the phrase from the work of Horace. The work is known as Ars Poetica, jisko English mein art of poetry ke name se bhi jane jate hain. Usme ye phrase tha art pictura poesies. And the meaning of, what is the meaning of this phrase? That is, art as in painting, so in poetry. This is the meaning of this फ्रेज फ्रॉम द वर्क ऑफ होरेस. एंड इसका मतलब होता है इस पोइट्रिक कंपोजिशन में जो आर्ट्स पोइटिका है, ही एडवाइजेज, होरेस एडवाइजेज पोएट्स हाउ टू राइट एंड द आर्ट ऑफ राइटिंग पोइट्री एंड ड्रामा. पोइट्री एंड ड्रामा को किस तरीके से लिखना है, वॉट इज द आर्ट ऑफ राइटिंग, ही एडवाइजेज पोएट्स इन दिस वर्क ऑफ आर्ट ऑफ पोइट्री. नेक्स्ट वी हैव, हु अमंग द फॉलोइंग इज द ऑथर ऑफ अकाउंट ऑफ द अगस्टन एज इन इंग्लैंड इन 1759. इसको बताया गया ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ द ऑथर ऑफ द अकाउंट ऑफ द अगस्टन एज इन इंग्लैंड जो ये वर्क था. हु इज द ऑथर ऑफ दिस वर्क. वी हैव द ऑप्शन एंड द करेक्ट आंसर इज ओलिवर गोल्डस्मिथ. ओलिवर गोल्डस्मिथ द ऑथर ऑफ दिस वर्क ऑफ अकाउंट ऑफ द अगस्टन एज इन इंग्लैंड विच वॉज पब्लिश्ड इन 1759. 1759. Next question we have, in how many parts did Miguel de Cervantes publish his novel Don Quixote? We have the option, and the correct answer is option 3, two options. The first was published in two parts. Miguel de Cervantes' work, his novel Don Quixote, published, and the first was published in 1605, and the second part was of the same Don Quixote was published in 1650. So friends, these are the important questions. आप इसको please note down करते जाओ, क्योंकि मैंने जो questions हैं उनके important जो facts हैं, important जो information है, explanation के साथ में यहाँ पे मैंने describe किया हुआ है, explain किया हुआ है, so that you can easily understand the question and the form of the question and related details of that questions. Next question we have, Leighton Strachey's Eminent Victorians, which was published in 1918, carries biographical sketches of writers and public figures. Identify the list below the correctly mentioned those eminent Victorians. Yes, friends, this was the work Eminent Victorian by Leighton Strachey, and it was published in 1918, and it has a biographical sketches. It has a biography of the great Victorian, eminent Victorian writers, and we have the choose the correct option. Who were they? Those Cardinal Manning, Florence Nightingale, Thomas Edward Arnold, and General Gordon. These are the eminent Victorians gave a place, and they has a they were included in the eminent Victorians by Leighton Strachey. Next we have, one of the following statement about the eponymous scent of Dryden's Song of St. Cecilia's Day, which was published in 1687, is incorrect. Identify that statement. We have the options, and the correct answer is St. Cecilia was an Armenian devotee of a Christian faith. This was the incorrect statement regarding this work, Song of St. Cecilia's Day. All other options are correct. Next question we have, question number 15, which of the following novel does not belong to Nuruddin Farah's Blood Edition trilogy? Trilogy means it has a book in the work of the Blood in the Sun by Nuruddin Farah, and we have to find out which does not belong to this category, which does not belong to the Blood in the Sun. And the correct option is Knots. Knot is not included as a book, as a volume of the Blood in the Sun. And all other, Maps, Gifts, and Secrets, are the three parts or three books of this Blood in the Sun trilogy of Nuruddin Farah. Moving on to the next question of the video, who among the following proposed that the first Gulf War had never taken place? It was simply a hyperreal media generated spectacle. We have the option, and the correct answer is Jean Baudrillard. He was the French sociologist, and he proposed the view that first Gulf War had never taken place. Next question we have, Sir Thomas Browne's Urn Burial, which was published in 1658, was prompted by questions. This was the question, and the answer we have, the discovery of ancient burial urns near Norwich. This was the urn burial was related to a place, and the discovery of ancient burial place that was near Norwich. We have the next question, identify from among the following list those who that cannot be called war fiction. Yes friends, these the work, and we have to tell which of these are not, cannot be called as war fiction. We have the options, and the correct answer is A and C. A means a modern instance, which was written by William Dean Howells in 1882. And next we have The Age of Innocence, novel by American author Edith Wharton, which was published in 1920. These both are not a war fiction, means these are not related to war like novel. And all other, we have the Catch 22 and the Naked and the Dead. These both are the war fiction in this list, or in these four options. So the correct answer is, which are not, a modern instance and Age of Innocence. These two are not the war fiction novel. Question number 19 we have, who among the following writers was not the one identified with the movement of the 1950s England? Yes friends, there was a movement in 1950s that was known as the movement of 1950s in England, and we have to tell in these options who the writer was not involved, was not related to this movement. Jo is movement se related nahi tha, wo kaun sa aisa writer tha? We have the options and the correct answer, Roy Fuller. Roy Fuller was not the part of this movement of the 1950 England. Friends, this was a group of the poets who were from the England. No other poets, no other writers from the outside of the England or British, they were not involved in this movement of the 1950. Kingsley Amis, Philip Larkin, Donald Davy, these are the part of the movement of the 1950 England. Next we have, which of the statement of Michael Rebord, favorite book of modern verses, which was published in 1936, is not true? We have the option and the correct answer, the collection begins with the poems of Robert Bridges. These is not the statement, this is not the statement correct to this work, Modern Verses, which was published in 1936. All other options are correct. They are related to this work. Next we have 21. In the following series, which one has the all the poets correctly matched with their poems? We have to tell in this option who correctly matched pair. Ezekiel's Poet's Lover and Bird Watcher. These were the options correct. Ramanujan's work, Small Scale Reflections on a Great House, Torudat's Our Casuarina Tree, and Mahapatra's Sunset at Puri. These are the correctly matched poets with their work, and all others are not correctly matched. Next question we have, John Heywood wrote a facial interlude called The Four P's. Who were the Four P's? This is very important question, friends. Mostly in exams, and this question is repeatedly asked in your exams. If you are going for TGT level, PGT level, any state level exams of English literature, and also in UGC NET. So this is very important question. The Four P's by John Heywood, and the correct answer we have option 4: a palmer, a partner, apothecary, and peddler. These are the Four P's in the work, in the facial interlude of John Heywood, that was known as the title, The Four P's. Next we have question. The very last passage of the novel is given below. Identify that novel. We have to tell the novel. Here is the last line of the novel. Welcome, O life, I go to encounter for the millennium time the reality of experience, and to forge in the sympathy of my soul that uncreated conscious of my race. April 27, old father, old artificer, stand me now and ever in good stead. This is the last line of the work, of the novel, A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man by James Joyce, which was published in 1916. This is very famous novel, friends, and all other not the correct answer. A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man is the correct answer. Moving on to the next and the last question of this video. Francis Bacon's New Atlantis is about an utopian state called Bensalem. This was the correct answer. Bensalem was the utopian state by which the New Atlantis of the Francis Bacon was called. So friends, this was all we had in today's video. This was the first part of the July 2018 UGC NET English literature paper, and in my next video we will discuss the second part of this video, because 100 questions were there in that exams in the second paper. So we will cover all that questions in here at English Zone. Please stay connected for that and for all other important videos of English literature. Thank you very much for watching this.